You've got to fix that. So thank you for the work you're doing, and thank you for your support. And I would like to see if Logan Lamb could come up. Talk about Georiga.
Hey friends, so I'm Logan Lamb. I'm a cybersecurity researcher based out of Atlanta. I primarily do wireless cybersecurity research, but since it was election season and we all like to break things, I really, really wanted to get my hands on some voting systems. So I ended up going down to the elections office in Fulton County. I was attempting to speak with the election supervisor, Richard Barron, I think. And I was going to say, hey, I'm a local cybersecurity researcher. I'd like to do some good work and help you guys. Well, as you can imagine, I didn't get past the secretary. So she ran my card back to Richard Barron, and then they came back to me and let me know that all of the election systems in Georgia are actually handled at Kennesaw State University by the Center for Election Systems. So immediately I thought this was kind of wacky, right? It's like, what is this university doing with all these systems? So prior to sending an email to the director there, I figured I'd try and get some background information on the group and just see, like, who are these people? What do they do? So I checked out their website, and then, just fired off like the simplest Google dork ever. I was just like, hey, I'd like to see all of your documents and PDFs you have on this website, okay? Lo and behold, there were some really, really interesting documents that were already cached by Google, okay? I clicked one of the links, and what appeared to be in front of me was a list of voter names, okay? So at this point, I was like, is this real life? Is this happening right now? This was just a web server. So I went up a couple of directories, because it had like a directory structure in the route. And then I looked at their robots.txt, wrote a quick like bash script to curl everything off recursively. And then I went to lunch. Then I went to lunch, and when I came back, and I checked to see how much data I had on my computer, I had 15 gigs worth of data, y'all. It's crazy. Crazy stuff. So, amongst this 15 gigabytes worth of data, I had all of the voter registration information for everyone in Georgia, okay? So that includes names, addresses, birthdays, last four digits of your social, also your full driver's license number, which seems relatively innocuous, but you can actually use all that information to change people's registration for DMV. So that's just a whole other can of worms. Okay, what else was there? We had PDFs of election day passwords, and this seemed to be the same across all counties, okay? And there were also some GEMS databases, and like to this day, I have no clue what those were doing on that server. It's just a web server. And from what I could gather, it looks like this server was being used to disseminate information to all of the counties. And there was like a bulk update file, which had a bunch of voter registration information and a couple Windows binaries. The Center for Election Systems, they would actually tweet out every couple months and be like, hey, there's a new bulk update file that you all should go download and run on your systems. Well, yeah, so it looks like this hilariously insecure system was being used to disseminate information related to the election system. Well, I mean, it keeps getting worse, actually. So this web server is vulnerable to Droopageddon, okay? And Droopageddon is like the easiest exploit. It's easy mode. There are YouTube videos detailing how to pop boxes using Droopageddon. And this has been around since 2014, I think. And I'm pretty sure it's 2017 now, so that's no bueno. So, an attacker could trivially get root on this box that is being used to disseminate information. And amongst that information, that they are intending to disseminate are Windows binaries. I mean, come on. So, I mean, an attacker could very trivially implant malware at that. And, I mean, never mind actually getting root on that box and then more than likely being able to pivot in deeper into the Center for Election Systems networks. Just to reiterate, the Center for Election Systems, they handle provisioning every single DRE in Georgia, okay? So, I mean, it makes for a hell of a target. And they say that their testing networks are actually, they're partitioned, segregated from whatever network that I happen to gain access to. But given what we've seen so far, I don't think they have the discipline to really do that. All right, so, I found all this information, immediately questioned if this was real life, and then figured out the best way to actually get this resolved. Because at the end of the day, this is always about building more secure systems. So, I spent a day or two trying to craft an email to make it sound like I'm not some rando crazy guy who's getting into their networks. I sent that to the director for the Center for Election Systems, and I had a weird conversation with him, which I'll get to. So I sent him this email, and I didn't hear a response. I didn't wait 24 hours because I was really, really concerned about this. So I ended up getting his cell phone number and giving him a call, right? So I was like, "Hey, Merle, you got my email. You're actually fixing this, right?" And he, oh, gotcha. Yeah, so chatting with Merle King, he assured me they were going to fix this. So at that point, I dropped it. Fast forward to March. In March, I was working on the talk I'm going to be giving tomorrow, which you all should come to, Cable Tap. And over beers, working with my buddies, I was talking to Chris Grayson, and I hadn't told him about this work previously. So he went and double-checked what I had accomplished, and they had not remediated it correctly. So then, of course, I proceeded to download everything again, right, to see if they had actually made any changes. The system was, they fixed the droopageddon issue, but they were still using the server to disseminate information as recently as 2017. So he let an individual at KSU know who could actually get this issue resolved. They ended up bringing the FBI into it, and then I ended up having the feds come to my apartment unannounced, which for those of you who haven't experienced that, I don't recommend it. It's not fun. So I chatted with the feds a bit, and as far as I know, I'm told they've actually fixed this issue now. I haven't really looked into it because the feds are unhappy with me.
Anybody's moderating this, but I guess I have a mic. Yes?
I wanted to ask Logan if he could explain what the Jets databases that he found there are and what they might include. And what that will mean.
Yeah, so the Jets databases, that's where all of the votes are actually tallied. And I have no clue what those were doing on the server. Like, I don't have a real explanation.
Sorry. So the GEMS databases are not where the votes are tallied. Those votes are tallied on the GEMS machine. What we think this is, because we're looking at the dates of the files that were when they were uploaded, they actually come after the elections. So it's possible that those GEMS databases were tally totals that the counties then send up to the election center after the elections.
Any further questions?
Is there any move to open source election software?
I can't see who asked the question. Oh, a question about open source. There are two jurisdictions in the country, Los Angeles and Austin, Texas, Travis County and Los Angeles County, who are building open source voting systems, and the elections community is certainly aware of open source as a possibility, but right now there are none, as far as I know, in use in the United States.
So obviously open source is preferable to proprietary software. Both of these systems are fairly far along, but at this point they need money to do the development work. So if you know somebody who wants to invest in these systems, it would really help with replacing these machines if we had the open source systems, because they'd be cheaper.
My name's John Brakey, and I'm AV, and I spent 3 weeks in Wisconsin, and I was shocked when I found that in a lot of the counties that did not hand count, that they had installed into the DS series machine by ES&S SIM cards that have built-in virtual private network. And if you could elaborate how dangerous that is or whatever, I mean, this is crazy.
This is the last question. We're running over time here. So we see this a lot. We see VPNs. We see network connections that are not supposed to be there by law or by practice. We see VPNs. We see all sorts of terrible operations security practices in various jurisdictions all over the United States. I don't even think Wisconsin is the worst at all.
Yeah, great.
I wish we had more time to talk about this. But we're going to have to cut this off now because the next session is going to have to start. So thank you all very much for being here.